Sometimes in a video game, you full CBA. This is one of those times. Hey, what is going on, guys? It is Lachlan here, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Ark Survival here on the YouTuber server. So, first up, guys, hope you're all having an awesome Saturday, and I don't want to apologize. I can't even apologize for what happened last episode. So, if you guys missed it, a bunch of unfortunate events went down again. So that's three episodes in a row, I think. We had the bad episode in the ocean. We had the bad episode in the cave. I say bad. They were entertaining, but progress... Yeah, it didn't really happen much, did it? And then, so yeah, there was the ocean, there was the cave, and then there was the kind of cave slash ocean last episode. So, this episode, we're not touching caves, we're not touching oceans, and we're not touching caves or oceans at the same time. It's not happening. And if it happens, I'm gonna have another dead episode. So yeah, hopefully today we'll go on to have an enjoyable episode. Now you may be thinking, Lachlan, why are you on top of this cliff over here? So I had a chat to Miola about what we want to do about our house. And we decided that moving wasn't exactly the go-to thing to do. We wanted to stay here and he's already built a lot of things over here, as you can see, like his gates and whatnot, an enclosed area to protect the dinos and all that jazz. So what we're going to be doing very, very soon is starting up a new house. Now, I'm thinking of having my house up here. You know, where this was the trap where Miola put me up here for that one episode because I was killing too many dinos. And yeah, I don't know. I just feel like this would be a good place to have just for... Can you come over here, Bidjot? I need your assistance for a second. Actually, don't worry, you're good. So yeah, I was hopefully going to get something going here with a little bit of a setup. Now, I want to get rid of these things over here because obviously there's no point in having them anymore. So I'm just going to go ahead and destroy them. So let's go ahead and demolish. There we go. And I'll get all the resources from them because we're going to need a lot of wood and a lot... Now, do I want the spike wall? If he'd done it good, I would have been down, but it's not symmetrical. So no, I'm going to get rid of that. And I can't, unfortunately, put foundations down, which is... Oh, spike walls actually work like that. I thought it was like individual pieces. No, it's like three of them at once. So there we go. Get the wood from all of these spike wall traps and demolished all around. So now we're left with this platform of ceilings. Now, what has he got underneath here? What is this thing? Is it like a... It's a wood pillar. Alright, and that's how this whole thing is being stood up. It's being stood up on a wood pillar. Because what I imagined was to have some kind of, like, slippery slide all the way down. And then, I guess, a ladder to come up as well. You can't build ladders. Yeah, I'd probably get a ladder going. And, I don't know. I just think life from up here would be so dope. So, yeah, I think I'm going to continue the ceiling going. Now, as far as this house down here, we're going to leave it for now. We're not going to do any key builds this episode. But I want to try and get a secondary... So this is hard. I don't know how I want to do this. Because I'm not sure if Miola wants us to have the same house and share it, or if we'll split up. I'd honestly be down to maybe even split up a little bit, just to have little things, I don't know, working a little bit differently. Either way, I'm going to work on what I'm going to call the bird's eye nest, or whatever this thing, what do they call it in a ship? I think it's called the bird's eye nest. That's it. It's not a bird's nest, it's a crow's nest. And this is essentially going to be the crow's nest. We're going to see all over the kingdom. Do they have sharks now? Oh boy. They've got sharks. Also, apparently last episode, I saw one of the rarest underwater, like, things ever. The Mosasaurus. Apparently, it's like the equivalent, people were saying, of like a Gigantosaurus underwater. And I didn't even know. But those things take like 20 arrows of Trank arrows to even take down. So, I wonder if it's still down there. Don't care, because we're not going to the ocean. So, that's, yeah, it's absolutely not happening. So, as far as things going, I'm going to learn a wooden pillar. Or I might just start learning these pillars from the engrams. Because, like I said, I just want to get some building done in today's episode. So, let's learn the wood pillar. Let's learn the steel pillar. And I don't even know if I'm going to bother with metal pillars later down the line. Nah, I'll leave that for now. I need a metal foundation. What's a... Oh, I haven't even got a metal foundation yet. So, honestly, yeah, I'm thinking we might separate just up a little bit here. And I'd like to have my own chests and whatnot. So... This could be kind of cool, I guess, in a sense. So let's just build an absolute crap ton of ceilings. And we're going to need a lot of thatch all the way around here. I'm thinking we'll go for a 5x5. What do you think, Pidgeot? Let's have a look. Let's have a bird's eye view of the crow's nest right now. So let's see. 5x5. It's currently... Well, when I finish, it'll be 3x3. And then expanding it out a little bit. And I kind of want to go, like, have a little downstairs segment. Like, that goes down to the rocks. Oh, I'm excited for this. This is going to be so fun. Alright, so, we need some wood to actually build this thing. Also, as well, guys, I have been doing a little bit of off-screen work. I got a bunch of metal things. Also, of course, repaired my armor. Which, that was a nice zoom in, Lachlan. Sick zoom. Yeah, I went ahead and got a ton of metal. It's still smelting, I believe. Oh, wow, I didn't even... Yeah, it needs more wood. Okay, but yeah, it's still smelting. I had an absolute crap ton. Did a couple rounds with Pidgeot and whatnot, but hopefully 55 metal should last me a good wee while. And this bird's nest, it's just going to be a nice separate house. Like, I think how we'll do this is we'll have a house each, and then we'll have our hub house as well, where we'll have all of our main things. But I just want to have the stuff to put all my items neatly arranged and all that jazz. Plus, I'd like to actually help with fencing in the rest of that place. But I think he's already done most of it, actually. Let's have a look, because I haven't done... I haven't done any building this season. I did the building with House of Miss Miola, but he's done all of this, which is actually real full-on. Real full-on. Like, crazy. So yeah, I think we'll probably build our house, like, around here or something on the water where I actually had my first little community house. I think we actually might build it there. Our actual it's gonna be a two-story mansion. At least it's gonna be lit. What the hell is this? Hello? What are you? What? It's Little Girl 20's dinosaur, Hummingbird. Okay, I remember this guy. He was not blood red the last time I saw him. Have you got a poo there? Oh, it's a trike egg. Okay. What else have you been mating with? What's this one? It's another one. Guys, how did they get a... I want to keep this. It's so rare. Look, it's just blood red. Even his eyes. Even his eyes are red. Okay, and then in other news as well, guys, Miola has gone ahead and moved our little dirty... I want to say dirty little attempt of trying to get some crops going, and he's moved them over here. Now, I think we're going to wait for each other to try and go in and tame some scorpions. He's got it, like, all irrigated with water and whatnot, so big ups to that. I really wanted to look at that stuff later down the line, but it is just kind of crazy. And I've got some compost bins, which you put hide and animal feces in to get, yeah, fertilizer, which lasts a lot longer. And obviously, you have to keep them fertilized, or otherwise they die, which my other crops did die last episode. They died because they were not fertilized enough. I wonder if I can harvest the actual crops. I wonder if I can do this right now. Wait, just chill for a second there, buddy. Chill, Pidgeot. All right, let's see here. All right. Oh, there's some rock arrows there. Okay, we can actually make some bug repellent, guys. Now, there's four major crops. It looks like he's got all of them down right here. I can't really access, like, all of these. All right, there, and there's the two we need for the bug repellent. We might have a look. There's some long grasses there. I think we might just have a look at a little bit of bug repellent. Make some up for the actual episode, because I know he's done until Monday, and I don't want to go ahead and do that without him. So I'll make some of that stuff. But like I said, I want to get some building done up there specifically. So, but I want to do it before the thing runs out or it spoils. Okay, let's do that before it spoils, okay? Let's make some bug repellent. Oh, and this thing right here, we're destroying it. I made a decision. I don't care if I'm wasting obsidian or whatnot, but it just being in the way, I've already emptied it. It's just not good for the room, and it's destroyed. So we got crystals, oil, and some other things. Cool. It just had to happen. It was in the middle of the room. It was a dumb idea to put it there in the first place. So that is gone now. Now I won't destroy this place because Matt still uses it as a home, and the bed's still here and whatnot. But let's actually think I might go for a little bit more stone actually up there because I like wood. I'm not going metal. I don't have the resources for metal. I just don't have the resources. All right. Anyway, so these things spoil in around 2 minutes. Wow, that is close indeed. How long do they spoil? Yes, 2 minutes. We have 2 minutes to make a bunch of this. Okay, drugs. Bug repellent, we're gonna need some pelts. I don't understand why they need pelts, but pelts and narcotics. Now, actually, funny enough, before Little Girl 20 left the server, she actually gave me a bunch of things, because she actually did steal all my items, or some of them at least, most of my tools, and so she made me all these tools as, like, a gift, but of course, we ended up changing the password, because the password got leaked, and obviously, you know, I talked about it a couple episodes back, but honestly, I think I might use some of these things right now. I'm gonna take the train carriers, and she gave me a bunch of narcotics, so thanks, Little Girl 20. Cheers, dude. So yeah, I'm gonna use this narcotics over here and hopefully go ahead and make us some... Oh, we need the pelts. Pelts. You know, I was watching the Revenant movie and, like, they're all about talking about their pelts and whatnot, so I don't even know why I made that point, but, like, yeah, it's all based on, like, the moon, the pelts, and... Sick story, Lachlan! Great one! Anyway, moving forward, we're making some bug repellents. Now, what are we gonna run out of first? Probably the pelts, Probably the pellets, I'd say. Yeah, I mean, I want to make as many of these as I can, so let's just grab all the pellets here. And I know pellets are hard to come by, kind of-ish, because I know we want to get some winter clothes going soon to travel into the winter places, but at the same time, bug repellent, it does actually spoil. I'll have to chuck this in the preserving bin. That's interesting. I did not know that. I did not think a bug repellent would spoil. I said I wasn't going to get a centipede, but I kind of think I might have to, because I don't want to waste the bug repellent. And I guess I'll eat just raw carrots all day or something. Let me see if I can actually cook the carrots or whatnot. Just like basic cooking. Like, can I actually cook these? Like, if I light these and then just chuck in some... Wait, no, I need to grab them out of here, actually. Hold on. Consumables, drugs, bug repellent, craft all. I probably shouldn't actually... No. Clear craft crew. I'm not going to craft them because I want to keep the pelts for maybe next time. And the narcotics. So yeah, let's try and put these into the preserving bin. Let's see here. Spark powder. Oh, let's put the track egg here in as well. And let's put the bug repellents in. How long are they going to last? Seconds, minutes, hours, days. Okay, so they'll last for 2 days, assuming there's enough spark powder. I don't know what the withdrawal rate is on the preserving bin. So, yeah... Hopefully there's enough spark powder there. Alright, so anyway, like I said, we're building the wood ceilings up there, so we're going to need to get some materials. I'm going to grab a bunch of things and chuck them on our boy Pidgeot to take up with us. I'm going to need a bunch of wood, a lot of wood, some thatch as well. I think the wood that we get from the thatch should be enough. So let's go here. Oh, sorry, the thatch from the wood, because we're using a hatchet here. Alright, let's just get like 180 pieces. And I love that Pidgeot over here can actually hold so much, because you can just like pop them all in. And Pidgeot's good to go, so we go, just chuck in the wood, and perfect, and then, oh, I don't have a sickle on me, oh, I'm gonna, I'll craft the sickle in a bit and get some fibers, because I'm surely gonna need that, a bunch of stone, of course, gonna need that regardless, let's go, alrighty, let's get this sickle going, weapons, melee, we're gonna need a piece of wood, wow, do I not have any of it in there, okay, come here, buddy, I took all the wood, it seems, so, gonna go put that back. Yeah, we'll put a solid 50 in there. You know, you always need wood for random things. In fact, actually, do I sell those crystals? So I'm going to take those crystals back out and, make myself a spyglass. Because, honestly, from the crow's nest, you're going to need yourself a spyglass really badly. So, spyglass. There we go. Craft item. And I'll chuck the rest of those bad boys into here. And then wood over here as well. Okie dokie, that should be enough for me to make myself melee and a sickle. There we go, perfect. And as far as things that I can unlock for crafting, I can now get a Rex saddle, a Carno saddle, I can... What were saddles were there? Oh, one that actually really applied to me and I really wanted to try and actually get was a beaver or castoroid saddle. So if I can just do a quick scout right now to see if there's any high level beavers around. Could you actually stop, Pidgeot? You're giving me issues here. How much weight do you at right now? You can actually, okay, you could hold a little bit more on you, couldn't you? Yes, you could. Yeah, I should have checked what level this beaver is, because if he's like level 40, 50, I might go and try and kill a Carno, get some prime meat, knock this guy out, to be honest. 7. Nah, that's not what I'm looking at. But you do come with awesome pelts, so I'll tell you what, buddy. I'll fudge you up 5 free, because I love me some pelts. You took the pelts, Pidgeot. You took the pelts. I think I hear a beaver on the other side of the wall. Yeah, there's this beaver over here, he's mad. He's mad I took his pelts, dude. Alright, what level are you? If you're high level, I'll mess with you. Alright, let's see what level this guy is. Let's just have a look, see what he's on about. Alright, what level are you, buddy? What level are you? 30. Wait, he's attacking the wall. Alright, absolutely not. Sorry, buddy. We have a strict schedule here. Okay, and tranquilizer arrows on now. Let's get ourselves a beaver, guys. A high-level beaver, too. Alright, I want to set to passive, too. So, passive. Alright, and... Oh, I got him one. Alright, okay. He's still distracted. There's two. I wonder how many it'll take to actually knock this guy down. And will I kill him first? Or will he kill me first? Oh, he's taking the damage. Oh, what? Woo! What's going on? No glitches, please. And no deaths, please. I promise my audience. What is he... It's like weird little... Is he hitting me? He's unconscious. Okay. 8 arrows. But it's like these weird... Like, look at that. What is that? Okay, it's gone now. I was like, what the hell is that? All right, so this guy actually eats berries, doesn't he? All right, so unfortunately, this guy is going to be a really hard tame. And it's mainly because he actually eats berries. So I can't get easy, like, raw prime meat for this guy. And also... It is getting really dark. Let me see how we can work with you here. I've got narcotics, which I might have to use, like, literally every last one of them. He also eats vegetables, so I might go and grab some of those vegetables. Oh, that did a lot, actually. Let me go try the vegetables out. I never really tried them before, but I know he can't eat them. I love how it's like, yeah, guys, gonna be doing some building today, and then just, yeah, at next minute, we're getting a tame. But honestly, it's one I want really badly, so I'm not even mad. And I'm gonna take the lightsaber because he is much quicker. Alright, let's see if those carrots do any good for our boy. I'll just have to pay attention to him. His unconscious level's going down quite crazy. So I'm gonna have to top up his torpor every now and again. Look at this. One narcotic raises him up to 6. Okay, it raises him up 40 points, 50 points. 50 points, and then it comes back down. He's losing more than a torpor a second. I just want to test something right now. If I hit him with an arrow, how much will it raise his torpor by? Let's go. That's a decent amount, actually. I could see myself doing that as an option for making him go. It's actually worth the... Yeah, it is actually worth it. It's worth me taking half of these and making these arrows into trank arrows and then shooting him with it. Because it scales with damage. So I do more torpor by just hitting him with an arrow. Problem is, he might die. So, you gotta be careful about that one. I don't want to lose this tame. And if I lose him, that'd really suck. Now, I think I saw another red thing over here somewhere. Like another red triceratops or something. Like that, like the hummingbird one. I thought I saw one. Okay, guys. So, 20 minutes later, I think it's been. And we are... I don't know why I just looked down as if I had a watch. Because I clearly don't. Now, I don't know what to call this guy when he gets, like... fully tamed. I don't know what to call him. Like, it's gonna come up and all the pressure's gonna hit me at once and we're like, I don't know what to tame you, dude. Is that last? That one? Oh, he's gonna eat one more time and he's good. I just hope I don't have to hit him with any more unconscious torpors and whatnot, because I realize that shooting him with the arrows, yes, it does inject him with more torpor, but it lowers his taming effectiveness. I looked back at the footage. It was plus 16 or 14 before. Now it's plus 8, and that's from me hitting him. He doesn't like it when I hit him, guys. So we're going to wait for him, and hopefully he will eat his next rock carrot and be good to go. Should be good to go. I just hope I don't have to hit him with an arrow because I'm out. Guys, I might have to do this. I might have to do this. If he doesn't eat this, when is he going to eat? He's going to eat in... Okay, this has to hit 50... Or that has to hit 0. I think it's 0 and he wakes up. It better not be 0. It should actually be the tilt. Like, this would actually tilt me off the fucking universe. Thank God for that one. Whew! Alrighty, we are in the money. Castoroid has been tamed. And I'm gonna name him Beaver. I'm so original. It's actually unreal how original I am. So yeah, Mr. Beaver over here is going to be... Actually, you know what? Can I just change that name? Because I just made it more original. Your name is now Mr. Beaver, all right? You're Mr. Beaver, all right? And we're going to make you a saddle. He is level 38. It's quite a high level for a beaver. And getting these guys apparently are a pretty good tame, especially for swimming. But they will run low on air, so this is going to be risky to use him in the ocean. But we're not going to the ocean today, so that's for another episode. I'll have to make you up a saddle in a bit, but off screen while I was waiting for that guy to tame, I went ahead and foraged some more resources on our birds. I got a piece of metal there, I don't know why I have that, but yeah, I got some wood and stone, and over on this guy over here, I got more wood and stone. So we're going to fly our Pidgeot over, we're going to call the Argentavis over, and these two guys are going to have to stay here for now, and I'll come back and give him a saddle later. But yeah, definitely excited to have a high-level beaver on the team, especially one that I can ride. Alright, so here's what we've all been waiting for, the part where we're going to build things, alright? So we're just going to build a little mini base for us, and we're going to be coming back in here and hopefully building upon it in the next couple of episodes, and should be kind of exciting. Hopefully I'm going to be able to get 2 videos for you guys out today on the second channel. We'll see how we get... Oh, for that... If I just died just then, I actually would have CBA'd out of fucking control then. Alright, Pidgeot, come back down here and pick me up. We're gonna need to get that ladder done sooner than later, okay? The ladder has to happen sooner or later. Sooner than later, because I'm gonna kill myself if I don't get this ladder. Actually going to kill myself. Like, literally, KYS. Alright, and we're good now. Offer f- Are you serious? Alright. We good? No? We good? We're good. Okay. Don't worry, guys. We're good. Okay, here is our, it's our canvas to paint, okay? And we're going to make sure this is lit as fudge. All right, so let me take my materials. All right, I'm going to start crafting things as I go. I've actually got a lot of weight on us right now, but it's fine. I'm going to start things off by getting some chests going. Or no, actually, let's get some more ceilings going. Let's get a bunch more ceilings going. What am I running low on to craft these? There's 60 wood apiece? Damn, Daniel. All right. We're going to need a lot more wood. I think I might go down there and craft more ceilings. But I'm going to grab all the wood for my pidgeots. Thank God we got those beaver dams down there who collect wood for us for a living. So that's going to be actually really great to have those guys on board. So let's see. Where I want to start placing these. Why can't I place that there? No nearby foundation support. All right. So we have to have a foundation thing there. That's fine. Okay. So one there. And I'm thinking one here. And then I'll probably have to get another foundation. What do we need for a foundation? Let's see. Support beam pillar. There we go. So we can do a stone pillar, or we can. I actually wouldn't mind the stone trim of a pillar. I wouldn't mind doing that actually. Let's go for some stone pillars. It'll look cooler. Now my only problem is that one of them is already, one of them is already kind of wood, and if I remove that, the rest is just gonna fall down. All right, I'm gonna leave them wood for now, but I just want to ask you guys at home, could you? Sometimes in a video game, you full CBA. This is one of those times when you literally glitch through a rock and... Yeah. Sick one, Pidgeot. It was all you. Now, I'm actually kind of excited here. I'm inside a place I'm not meant to be! What could I do here? Can I make a house in here? This could be actually low-key lit as fudge. Alright. Can't place a stone... Oh, dude, I can actually build a fucking house in here! Alright, wait up. I want to build a house in here. Alright, wait up. But how would I get back inside? I don't know how I'd get back inside. Alright, let's place a stone pillar here. Alright, and this is going to be my place. Alright, wait up. I want to have my mark here somewhere. I want to, like, put, like, a sign down. Oh, no, I can't place it here. It's obstructed. No. I don't know how that was obstructed, but that clearly wasn't. Alright, now let's test the boundaries and see if I can leave this place. Well, that was easy. Can I go back in? But I want to go back inside! Not gonna lie, it's pretty bad, but if I died, I just would have been massive full tilt. Because I wouldn't have been able to get back in, and I would have just lost all my items. I actually would have probably rage quit if that had happened, because I didn't deserve that. Like, that would just be dumb, alright? But it didn't happen, so don't worry. But I'm really scared about having you guys up here because you're really starting to put me on edge, like real edge right now, guys. All right, so I'm going to quickly make a little portable storage box for up here as well. I'm actually going to make a small one. I just need a little piece of wood here. Actually, no, I'll make a large one. This is going to be for pure resources. It's not going to be a part of the house later down the line. It's going to be removed later as well. Like, yeah, it's going to be removed later, so don't worry. I'm actually out of wood, so that's awkward. All right, this is great. Alright, so I'm going to actually try and build the ceilings because I think they're so much lighter than the actual pieces. So I'm just going to craft them here and then chuck them on first. I think that's probably the most resourceful way. How much do they weigh each? I'm actually surprised here. They are... Wait, why isn't it... Where are they in my inventory? Oh, they're here. They are 40 each. No, they're 4 each. The 4 each. That was times... Oh, wow. Okay. Let's just do this. Let's just literally pull them out of the dam and then just craft them. Like, 100%. Like, let's just go wooden ceiling and just go bang, craft all three. I think we're running low on... Yeah, running low on thatch. Oh, look, guys. That's one of those new dinosaurs. Hey, dude. Hey, dude. How are you? Hey, dude. Do you drop pelts? I know. I won't kill you because you look so adorable. Apparently, they do backflips and stuff. So, that'd be pretty lit, actually, having a backflipping... Whatever they're called, they have a weird name. Lysaurus. Alright, so I think I'm going to go ahead with wooden pillars instead of pillars. That's so American. Pillars. I'm going to go with wooden pillars instead of stone because there's already a wood one out there. So I'm going to craft these bad boys. And I think I'm going to head off. So let's get everything that's on here so we don't have all this weight on us. And I think that is 56. He's now got 160. I think we can now ride him. all that material. Okay, perfect. Plus, we got a bunch of wood up there. I mean, obviously, it would be better to have the materials by our side and then build by build, but I think building them in your inventory first and then taking them up would probably be the better idea. And I wonder if Matt has some spare materials as well. But either way, I might just off screen before I start my next episode, just make a lot of the stuff and then try to place it in the episode just so you guys see all that kind of process. I don't know. What do you guys think? I think that'd be a happy medium. I'm also going to need some kind of place. Oh, don't tell me. Okay, good. I was like, please don't go off to the right. That would be deadly. But yeah, I'm going to have to look at some other ways to get this working. But yeah, I'm definitely going to need like a landing pad for birds. Like, that's one of the first things. I'll build it here. I'm going to build it up here. And I would have like, the little cubby house is going to be down there. That's where I like have the full view. And I might not make that into wood. I might make that something fancy, like metal or something. That could be lit. But it'd be very resource intensive. So I'd have to see. Okie dokie. So, let's get this party started. I want more ceilings over here. Oh, that's just flush with the wall. Perfect. Oh, except over there it doesn't actually turn that way. So, I'm wondering if I want to expand it out one more. Or do I have to... I have to get some support beams in that. But I'm thinking that might be a good idea. Is have another... Because I would love for this to be flush with the wall like that. And these two are there, but this one just ruins it. Alright, either way, we need to get some support down here. I hope we have enough pillars to work with this. Pillars! Hope we have enough pillars to work with this. Alright, so let's go down here and see if this is going to work. So I'm thinking it'll probably go like there. And then that needs... Does that need to go down to the ground? Or is that... It probably needs to go down to the ground. So there we go. That is probably not touching the ground and it's aesthetically unpleasing. So that's like in itself there. Okay, there we go. That should be nice and... Nice and sick. Alright, see this right here, that's actually freaking bannable, dude. Like, what the actual? No. Demolish. Oh, no! Alright, let's see if I can demolish this beam here so it'll be flush. Hold. Okay, good. Alright, so, let's put a... one there, and I want to try and position this nice and right so that it doesn't go through the wall. And how would I know, to be honest? That fully went through it again, didn't it? And I just wasted all my time, didn't it? Screw it, I'll put like a... I'll get rid of that room. Yep, I know what I'm going to do. There's going to be a wall there. And it's just going to be in the middle. Yep, screw it. Fudge you. Alright, and then as far as ramps go, we're going to have this thing ramp down, I guess, can I get this to work? Yep, perfect. Alright, yeah, it's going to be like that. It's going to ramp down. Alright, and then one more there is where, whoa, why wouldn't I put a ramp there? Come on, ramp it, buddy. There we go, ramp it. Perfect. Okay, so that's going to be like the stairs down, and then it's like... So this is going to be like the main room where all my chests and whatnot are. This is going to be the landing pad. I'm going to get this sorted out later though. I'm going to probably have a different thing there. It's going to be like, I wonder if I get like a H somehow, like a circle with a H. That'd be cool. But yeah, I'm going to have this blocked off with wood because I don't like that. That's disgusting. I can't believe it let me do that. If anyone has any ideas, let me know. But I'm pretty sure if I break that support, it'll break everything else. And then I'll be fudged 5 free. I'm probably going to need to put another support beam here as well. Can I craft one? I can't. Oh, I can actually. I have one left. But it's out of placement range. Okay, so if I was to place one... I wonder if I can still put ceilings down. Can I still put ceilings down? No snap point. Alright, I'm going to try and place another one closer to it in the middle here. So it'd be about... there. And I need to make another one. I guess it'll be a little uneven, but as long as it's... it'll be fine. It actually looks almost perfect. Or maybe I could have a pillar here and it could just go through the whole house and it could be a cool little... I could see that being a cool little thing. I wouldn't mind that, actually. Alright, so if I put this here, what's the snap point and is it good? Oh, it's not high enough. Thoughts here. And I know this sucks, but I'm demolished again. It's all guess and check, unless there's a better way. But I'm a very noob builder. So I'm going to try and get the additional height that I'll get from about here. And then I need to move it back anyway. So about there and... Wait, can I put it up higher than that? No, I can't. There and there. How does that look? That looks like perfect. All right, moment of truth, ladies and gentlemen. Please. Oh, you suck so bad. You suck really bad. Wait a second. What if I just... It's so dodgy though. No, it has to be perfect. Ah, idea. At least I'm getting some of these resources back, but idea. I'm gonna start placing them under here instead. Now if it goes through that, that'd be really Ebola. But I think I might be able to get this to work. Can I shoot myself with an arrow right now? Like, is that a thing? Can I do that? Can I like just like shoot it up and then hope it like lands on me or something? Like, is that a thing? Like, can I catch the arrow or something? Like, is it coming back down? Is it coming back down? Can I catch it, please? Can I please catch it? Hello, Mr. Arrow, where are you? Tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and leave it for now. I'm going to ask you guys in the comment sections, the Ark builders out there. I might even get me. Oh, you can just fudge right off. Yeah, I want to ask some builders out there how they would go ahead and try to attempt this. But what I'm trying to imagine right now to relay to you guys is, oh, for fudge sakes, is some kind of like way where like, okay, so this is how I imagine it. All right. So I've got my landing pad over here for dinosaurs that I want to come in on a bird. It has to be big enough to support a Quetzal. Okay. So make sure that's in the plans. Then this over here, this room is going to be the storage room. This is going to be the storage wall. All of my materials are going to be lined up with storage crates here, and there's going to be machines all the way throughout here. And then down here, I'm going to have your pestles and mortars, your preservery bins, my cooking stuff, all that's going to be here. But my fabricator and my smithy and all that's going to be on this side of the wall. And then probably some cool little roof if I can. Then down here, I'm going to have like a little middle tin. And it's going to be like another little cubby house box. And in there, I'm going to have, I don't know, a bunch of other random things and a lot of windows. And yeah, that's what I'm trying to imagine. But yeah, guys, unfortunately, I'm going to have to go ahead and wrap the episode up right there. I hope you guys have enjoyed. I'm trying hard to make myself a cool little house. I might even, I don't think I'll scrap this. I'll try to see with Matt what we can end up doing. But I might end up just making one big house with Matt. Or no, I want to keep this as a side project for my own house. So hopefully I'll get some good feedback from you guys and be able to work with these pillars. If not, I might have to scrap it if the pillars are just going to be jags. Because I don't want uneven, like, they're not touching each other. Like, I'm not, I don't know, OCD like that. But yeah, anyways, guys, hope you have an awesome Saturday. And I will catch you guys tomorrow for a brand new episode of Ark Survival. Later, guys.